Then good morning. And today's topic is field dependency. Here, what is a field dependency? The field dependency in Salesforce are a special type of filter. Here, one field depends upon another field. The field value, for example, branch is a one field. Here, for example, employee belongs to CSE branch. You will select the courses corresponding to the CSE. A department courses, for example, Java only. Then, for example, DBMS. Like that, the faculty will select those corresponding courses. That is a filter. Here, it is a special type of filter that helps us to change the content of pick list based on the value of another field. It will change the content of the pick list. For example, the best example here is the country. The country in a single pick list. For example, India. If you select the India, automatically you will select the states of India. The states of India here is Andhra Pradesh. Here the country is one field, a state is one field. Let us assume. If you select the country India, you have to display the corresponding fields of corresponding state fields. For example, corresponding Andhra Pradesh, Karnataka, Tamil Nadu. Like that, that means it will display the all field value. That is called here field dependency. Here country is a control field, state is a dependent field. And then coming to the example two, for example, if you come to the food items, where deciding from the long list is time consuming. In order to doing that one, you have to select the breakfast food. Breakfast food items, lunch food items, dinner food item. Then easily identify what are the breakfast food item. Then you will pick up one food item and then eat it. Like that, you have so many differences are there. And then coming to the another example, for example, you have a faculty. The faculty wants to select a particular subject. How can you select the particular subject? For example, he belongs to a CSE department. He will select the only particular CSE subject. Here you have ECE related subjects are there, EEE related subjects are there, but here he can select the only CSE related subjects. That is a thing. Another important one here is a field dependency is a drop down list filter. That means it comes from the pick list filter. Yeah, it will controlling the dependent field. Always the field, one field controlling the dependent field. Easy to summarize the pick list values. For this purpose, main purpose here, you are using the, in order to reducing the time. Within a particular time, you will select the particular pick list values. That is the main reason you have a field dependency. Here, for the field dependency, two types of fields are there. One is a controlling field, another one is a controlling field, another one is a dependent field. What is a controlling field here? That means control the available values in a one or more corresponding dependent field. Always it will controls the different values. Here branch, for corresponding branch, CSE branch, it will select the corresponding CSE subjects. The branch here is a controlling field. Dependent field. Here, the dependent field to display the values based on the values selected for the corresponding controlling field. Here, we are selecting these values for the corresponding control field. Yeah, we move to the practical laboratory. If it comes to here, already you have one application. That application, that means it is a sales application. The application consists of these are all objects, and then already previously designed one application, college information system. In the college information system, you have a college department, and then EMP are the fields. Here, EMP consists of EMP number, E name, employee salary, and then department number. In addition to these fields, I want to add another field. Another field here is a branch The next field here, one is a branch field, another one here is a subject or course field. Here I am going to adding some fields. For example, the first field, branch field. Branch. The second one is a subject or corresponding courses. Courses field. The branch in the sense, it belongs to, for example, branches may be CSE branch. Let us take ECE branch, IT branch, TBE branch. Like that, you have a different branches are there. Corresponding subjects in the sense, you have a Java, you have a C programming, you have a another one here is a DSP, digital signal processing system. Another one here is a embedded systems. Another one here is a digital logic design. Let us assume you have a different branches are there, different sections are there. How can you design these two fields in Salesforce? Here, come here. I want to add one field in this. How can I add in this field? First, go to setup. Here, there is a create option is there. Go to objects. And then comes to, you want to create the new field. For which you are going to create in the new field? For employee. For the employee, I'm going to create in the new field. I'm going to create in the new field. Where you are creating the new field? Employee consists of employee number, employee name, employee salary, and then department number. Four fields are there. I want to add another field. Here comes to the custom fields and relationship. Custom fields and relationship. And then here, click on new button. Click on new button. First, I am going to create in the new field. How can I create the fields here? Here, I am taking the pick list. Pick list. Branch is a pick list. Next. The field name. The field label here is a branch. I am writing the branch is a field label. Okay, capitalized. Branch, it's a global none the values here. That means you are going to description, not having any description. Enter the that means not a global values. I'm going to entering the my values here, CSC and then ECE and then triple E. Okay, enough. Triple E branch, CSC, ECE, triple E branches are there. And then the pick list value. Next. Okay, next. Save it. Okay, save it. Save on next one. Comes to the next one, also a pick list. Select the pick list. Where is pick list? Here, pick list is there. And then go to next. The pick list courses. Which type of courses are selected? Entering the courses. I am entering the courses like a Java, C programming, DBMS. Another one here is a DSP, digital signal processing system. Another one here is a embedded system. Another one here is a DLD. Like that, you have a different programming languages are there. You may include another languages also, no problem. Next. Next. Save it. Yeah, if it comes to the employee, if you go to the employee, how many fields are there? Only it will display the four fields. I need one extra. You added two fields. You added these fields to object. How can you add the fields to object here? Go to edit. Here, one is a branch field, add it. Another one is a course field, add it. Branch and course field, and then save. yeah, if it comes to the employee, great. Yeah, here we find the, we'll find out the one is a branch, other one is a course field. I am going to add in these values here. Yeah, come here. How can you add these values? For example, if you want to enter these values here, for example, employee number 04, the employee name, for example, Shiva, employee, the employee salary 6000, and then he belongs to which department here? The department number 10 belongs to CSE department. Department number 20 belongs to, like here, the department here is a CSE. The branch here is a CSE branch. Here, if you comes to here, courses, which course I am going to selecting? The employee, which course selecting for teaching? For teaching the student, which course selecting? But it is a very difficult to selecting these courses. That means I want to select the DSP, but DSP belongs to ECE branch. For example, I want to select a embedded system. Embedded system also belongs to me. That means there is a confusion as well as it's a time taking process. That's why there exists a field dependency. Here, the field dependency. Okay, how can you select the field dependency? Here, go to setup. Here, go to create. Click on create. Under create, there is an object, object field. Here, employee, for which object you are going to selecting the field dependency? For employee object, I am selecting the dependency. Click on employee. Here, you should come here. The custom field and relationship. If you comes to the custom field and relationship, for branch, for course and branch, I am going to selecting the field dependency. Here in this case, what is a controlling field? The branch is a controlling field. What is a dependent field? Course is a dependency field. Click on field dependency. Click on, I'm going to create a new field dependency. What is a controlling field here? The controlling field, branch is a controlling field. And then what is a dependent field? Course is a dependent field. For the quick list only, you will select in the field dependency. Course is the this field, and then continue. Click on continue. Here you will selecting the for CSE branch. What are the subject? For example, I am selecting the Java. I am selecting the DBMS for the CSE subjects, and then DSP, Digital Signal Processing System. A signal processing system, embedded system, and DLD belongs to, but I did not get it to anyone. No, nothing was there. Okay, the DLD also belongs to this one, ECE branch. Okay, save it. Three controlling fields values have no dependent value includes. Save it. Yeah, you save it. And then save. Then if it comes to the EMP, if you come to the EMP, go. Now I'm going to enter in the values. How can I enter the values? Employee, these are all different fields. New, here enter in the, see here, previously it is active position. Active position in the sense, for example, select as ECE, CSE, any value, it will show the value, the corresponding course value. If, for example, employee number 5, employee number, name Rama, Rama, employee salary 6000, and then he belongs to, for example, he belongs to CSE department. And then it belongs to branch, here is a CSE, then it will active. Okay, it takes some time. Yeah, if it comes to here, previously it shows, for example, if you select a CSE, it shows a Java and then DBMS. These courses belongs to Java and DBMS. For example, if you select a ECE, ECE courses belongs to okay embedded system, and then if you select the Triply courses are 80. Like that, you have to. That means you are saving time. Here in this case, branch is a controlling field. So this one is a dependent field. In this way, you will create the branch as well as the courses. For example, if you need another example, I can tell you. For example, we have a country. Country is a one. Let us take a simple example. For example, in used like a country. Country is a one field, and then within a field, a state is a another field. The state within a state, city is a another field. Let us assume three fields. Here, country. For example, the country India. Let us take. India is a country, and then England, another country. States are there. I don't know about the. I know India's state in Andhra Pradesh, AP, Karnataka, Tamil Nadu, Telangana. Like that, different states are there. Okay, for the England, I don't know the states of England. Okay, leave it. Yeah, comes to the okay. Leave the state. One city I am taking. For this city, how can you get this one here? For the city, India cities are Delhi. Let us take. Oh, I am taking some cities, Delhi, and then Hyderabad, and then Bangalore, like that, Chennai. Different cities are there. For example, England cities, Leeds. One city, the England cities belongs to one city belongs to Leeds. Another city, let us assume Wales. Another city, Oxford. Here, I know three cities. Okay, let us. This belongs to England. This belongs to some other Chennai. This belongs to India cities. I want to, based on these fields, I want to create a one pick list. How can I create the pick list for the employee? So for example, these employees belongs to. This is a thing. Here we have a country. Country is a one field. City is a another field. For the country and city, I am going to creating the pick list. Yeah, come to here. Here the first you need to creating the fields, two fields. For the employee only, I am creating the different fields. Employee belongs to country India. Employee belongs to country England. So for example, I want to create a object. For the object, I am going to creating the one field. How can I create the field? Come to here. Click on object. Yeah, and then new object, not new object. I am not going to creating the object. I am going to creating the field for the employee. Yeah. Here comes to the fields. Here already you have different fields are there. The custom field and relationship new. Here you will take the pick list. Yeah, select the pick list and then next the field name. The field name is a country. Country is the field name. Okay, small letter. It is a better country. And then the country values. I am taking only simple for easy to understanding. India. India is a one country. And then India is one country. And then England is a another country. England is another country. For country, okay, next. Okay, next. Seven, new field. Okay, the next field here is a, what is the next field? Country, city is a, another field. I'm taking the pick list. City, yeah, the field name, city. City values. I'm going to enter the city values. What are the city values? I already explained the city values. India, Hyderabad. Another value, city value, Chennai. Delhi. Let us assume India and then England. In England, what are the values? One is Leeds. Another one city here is Wales. Another one city, Oxford. Oh, let us okay. Enough these values. Next. Next. Save. Okay, if it comes to the employee, what are the fields for the employee? How many fields are there? Already you have some fields are there. Okay. I'm going to add another fields. What are the another field? The field values here is a country is a one field and then city is a another field. Totally you have 6 or 7 fields are there. Okay. I am going to enter in the values here. Yeah, how can I enter in the values in a fixed list? The field values. I'm going to enter in the field values. How can I enter? Yeah, go to and then create a new record. Here the record employee number equal to, for example, 7. The employee name equal to Rama, and then employee salary equal to 6000. The field dependent. Here it is a lookup table. Master table, for example, he belongs to CSC, and then CSC, then it will active Java course. And then what is the country for the employee Rama? Which country he belongs to? For example, India. In the India, I don't know about the city. He belongs to, for example, Oxford. If you select the Oxford, it is a totally wrong. If he is a clerk or some other person, in this way they will select. It's totally wrong. That's why you have to create the pick list for this field, for the these two fields. How can you create the pick list? In this case, go to setup and then comes to create. Here in the create comes to object and then click on employee. You should go to the custom field and relationship. Here you are going to create in the field dependency. Here I'm going to create in the new field dependency. The field dependency, the control, what is the controlling field? Totally you have different fields are there. The controlling field is a country and then dependent field is a city. For these two fields I'm going to create in the field dependency. For only field dependency applicable if data type is a pick list. Click on here and then you should select in the, that means click button include or exclude select value from the dependent pick list. For example, for the city I'm selecting Hyderabad, Chennai, Delhi, these are all, and then include. And then for the England, what are the city? Leeds, Wales, Oxford. These are all cities. Save it. Controlling field value, no dependent value, saved. Okay, no. Okay. Include this value. Okay. Include this value, save it. Yeah. Two field dependencies, save. Here, if you comes to here, I'm going to creating a new field. For the new field, for example, 6 is a employee name equal to some ABC. Let us assume ABC is the employee name, employee salary equal to 6000. He belongs to which department? For example, he belongs to EC department. EC, what are the EC department? EC department. Then it will active. Before that, if it's not active, the course value not active. Why? Because it is a depends upon a branch. I'm selecting the ECE. ECE, what are the ECE subject? Embedded systems. And then come to the country and city. Country is active, but city is in disabled mode. if you select the England, and then see what is the city, only it shows the three cities, Leeds. It automatically select the those values and then save it. In this way, you will create in the picklist value. Thank you.